Hi everyone, Monisha here. In this video, I will be completing three graphical problems on exercise 3.1 and example 4, 5, 6, which is also a graphical problem. In my previous video, I had explained first three example problems of pair of linear equations. I hope you understood everything. Please concentrate on this video itself and watch till the end. Let us start the session. So moving on to the first problem of exercise 3.1. So this is also a graphical problem. Here the statement will be given. We have to solve it to find out two equations, and after that we need to find out the points to plot inside the graph. Okay. So here, Aftab tells his daughter, 7 years ago, I was 7 times as old as you were then. Also, 3 years from now, I shall be 3 times as old as you will be. So represent this situation algebraically and graphically. Okay. So in this question, we need to find out the exact age of Aftab and his daughter by an equation, right? So let the present age, of Aftab be x. So let it be x years. Okay. So next, and his daughter, the present age of his daughter be y years. Okay. So let the present age of Aftab be x years and his daughter be y years. Next, in the question they have told 7 years ago. So 7 years ago means before 7 years. Aftab age will be 7 years ago, we need to count means we just have to subtract this present age with 7, right? So the Aftab's age before 7 years is x minus 7, right? And his daughter's age be before 7 years, his daughter's age is y minus 7. Okay, this is the present age. 7 years before means minus 7. 7 years before means minus 7 we had to do. This is 7 years ago. Next, read out the question. 7 years ago, I was means Aftab was 7 times as old as you were. So 7 years before, Aftab's age was 7 times than his daughter's age. So 7 years ago, Aftab's age was, we can write the statement of that. So 7 years ago, 7 times as old as his daughter. Okay, so Aftab was 7 times as old as his daughter. So Aftab's age before 7 years is x minus 7, and he was 7 times means 7 into. Okay. 7 into age of his daughter. Next, we need to simplify it to make it as an equation. Okay. So x minus 7 is equal to 7 into y, 7y minus 7 sevens are 49. So here x, I will be shifting the 7y this side, it will become minus 7y is equal to minus 49. This minus 49 I will be writing here itself, and I will be shifting this minus 7 to right hand side, it will become plus 7. So the first equation is x minus 7y is equal to minus 42. Fine. So this is equation number 1. This is 7 years ago. So next, after this, 3 years from now. 3 years from now means after 3 years. Okay. After 3 years. Now again, the present age is x. They are mentioning after 3 years in the future. Okay. So after 3 years, Aftab's age will become, after 3 years, present age is 7. After 3 years means plus 3, right? So x plus 3 years. So his daughter's age will be, so daughter's age is y plus 3 years, after 3 years. Okay, so after 3 years from now, I shall be 3 times as old as you will be. So Aftab is telling after 3 years, he will be 3 times as old as his daughter. Okay, so after 3 years, Aftab's age will be x plus 3, and he will be 3 times as old as, 3 times means 3 into, okay, 3 times as old as his daughter. Again, we need to simplify this. X plus 3 is equal to 3 into y, 3y plus 3 3s are 9. Next, shift this variable notation to this side. It x minus 3y, 9. I will be shifting this 3 this side, 9 minus 3. So it will become x minus 3y is equal to 6. This is equation number 2. Okay. So now we already got 2 equations here. We need to solve it to find out which type of graph it will be coming. Next, we need to plot the graph. Okay. The continuation of first problem is, here the first equation will be x minus 7y is equal to minus 42. This is the first equation. And second equation is x minus 3y is equal to 6. Okay. So here one variable is same. So there is no need of cross multiplying. Okay. So first change the sign. Here plus x and minus x get cancels each other. Here minus and plus, unlike signs, subtracts. Okay, so 7 minus 3 is 4y, whereas larger number sign is minus. So retain minus here. Next, minus into minus, that is like signs, we need to add. So 42 plus 6 is 48. Larger number sign is minus. Okay, here minus minus get cancels each other. Y is equal to 48 divided by 4. So 4 1s are, 4 2s are. Y is equal to 12. So this is the value for y, where we need to substitute this value to either first equation or second equation. Okay, I will be taking equation 2. Equation 2 is x minus 3y is equal to 6. X minus 3 into, in the place of y, we need to take 12 is equal to 6. So x minus 12 3s are 36 is equal to 6. So x is equal to 36 plus 6. So when I shift minus 36 to right hand side, it becomes plus 36. So x is equal to 36 plus 6 is 42. So this is the intersecting point. Okay, y is equal to 12 and x is equal to 42. How? When we make a1 by a2 and b1 by b2, this a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Okay, here a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Why? So a1 by a2 is 1 by 1, which is not equal to minus 7 by minus 3. Okay, so the graph will be intersecting. So next, we need to solve equation 1 by 1. X minus 7y is equal to minus 42. So here I will be shifting this minus 42 to left hand side and minus 7y to right hand side. It will become x plus 42 is equal to 7y. So y is equal to x plus, but I just reversed it. So when you are reversing both, the sign will not change. Okay, when you are shifting only one, so when you are shifting only one to either side, at only that time the sign will changes. When we are just shifting both the terms here and there, then it will not negate. Okay, keep that in mind. So 7y is equal to x plus 42. In the next step, y is equal to x plus 42 divided by 7. Okay, so this is the equation where we need to find out the points for this. So we need to take only those points so that we can plot the graph clearly and easily. So don't take many bigger points and all, and negative points, so that your graph will become even larger. Okay, so in the first point, I will be taking x is equal to 0. When I take x is equal to 0, only 42 remains, where 7, 6 are 42. Okay, in the first case, I will be taking x is equal to 0. So y becomes 0 plus 42 divide by 7, which is 42 divided by 7. 7 ones are 7 6 are. Okay. So when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 6. Right. So next number is, when I take 1 here, it will become 43, not divisible by 7. 2, 44, not divisible by 7. When I take 3, it will be 45, not divisible by 7. 4, 5, 6. When I take 1, 2, 6 numbers, it will not be divisible by 7 when the addition is done. Okay. So only when I take 7 here, when I take x is equal to 7, it will become 42 plus 7. That is 49, which is divisible by 7. Okay. So directly I will be taking x is equal to 7. If you have any doubt, you can do one by one from 1, 2, 3. Okay. Just for the time constraint, I am doing it directly 7. So y is equal to 7 plus 42 divided by 7. So 49 by 7. 7 ones are 7 sevens are. Okay. So when x is equal to 7, y is also 7. One more point is there, which we have already found out. So this is the intersecting point. We need to take x is equal to 42 here, because that is the point where the intersection happens. We need to show in the graph the intersecting point. If you are not showing, means the graph will be completely incorrect. Okay. So x is equal to 42. Y is equal to 42 plus 42. In the place of x, you have to substitute 42. Divide by 7. That is 84 divided by 7. 7 ones are 1 carry. 7 twos are 14. That is 12. So when we take x is equal to 42, y will be 12. Okay. So this is the points for first equation. Next we need to take the points for second equation. The second equation is x minus 3y is equal to 6. So shift it this side. X minus 6 is equal to 3y. So 3y is equal to x minus 6. Y is equal to x minus 6 whole divided by 3. So this is the equation. So next we need to find out the points. Fine. So here we can take 0, 1. If I take 0 here, the minus 6 will be remaining. If minus 6 is remaining, when I divide it, it will turns around minus 2, negative number. Okay. So in order to avoid a negative number, because the graph will come below. So in order to avoid that, you can take that also. It is not incorrect. It is also right. So but in order to avoid that negative numbers, I am taking positive number. Okay. Directly, I will be taking x is equal to 6. Because less than that, we can't divide by 3. If I take 1 here, it will be minus 5. We can't divisible it by 3. If I take 2, it will be minus 4. If I take 3, it will be minus 3, which will be minus 1. So again a negative number. So in order to just avoid it, I am taking 6 directly. Okay. You can take 3 also. So y is equal to 6 minus 6 divided by 3. That is 0 by 3, 0. So when we take 6, we will get 0. Okay. So next point is x is equal to 7. When I take 7 here, it will be 1, not possible. 8, 2 will be remaining, not possible. I have to take 9. Okay, x is equal to 9. So y is equal to 9 minus 6 by 3. So 3 by 3, 1. Okay, so when I take 9 here, it will become 1. So next, the last point is already there. That is, we need to take x is equal to 42, which is the intersection point. Y is equal to, that is 42 minus 6 by 3. 42 minus 6 is 36 divided by 3. That is 12. Okay. So when I take 42, we will get y as 12. So this is the intersecting point. So the graph will be intersecting. Now we need to plot the graph. Moving on to the graphical part. Here x-axis and y-axis I have already drawn. So x-axis, here the larger number in x-axis is 42. So if we take like 1, 2, 3, 4, then the graph will be very much enlarged. So that in order to minimize it, I have taken 1 centimeter is equal to 5 units. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40 and 45. Inside it, we can draw this 42, right? and in the y-axis the maximum number is 12. So I have taken 2 units to each centimeter. So 2, 4, 6, 8 up to 16. So the scale should be written as x-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 5 units and in y-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 2 units. Okay. Now we will start plotting the graph. So first is for 0, it will be 6. For first point, for 0, x-axis 0, the y will be 6. Okay. So this is the point 0, 6. Okay, this is 0, 6 point. So next one is 7, 7. That is for x-axis 7. You can see here. So this is 5. Okay, this one is next millimeter line is 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, so this is the 7th line. So this is 7. Fine. So this is 6 and 7. For 7, the value is 7 itself. Okay, so 7 is here 4. So the exact middle line will be 7 here. So 5, 6, 7. Okay. So here if you take it as, okay, sorry, 6 and 7, exact middle point. So this is 7. So 7, 7 will be here. Fine. So this is 7 and this one is 7. Fine. So 7, 7. This is 7, 7. Next one is 42 and 12. When x is equal to 42, so this is 42 line. When x is equal to 42, y will be 12. Okay, so 12 is here. Fine, x is equal to 42 and y is equal to 12. Fine, so this is the point 42, 12. Next, we need to draw a straight line. Okay, place your scale and using pencil, you need to draw a straight line. So here the straight line will not come because I'm not using scale. Okay, but you have to draw a neat straight line. Fine. So here it will touch the point. Okay, this point will touch maybe here because of scarcity of the scale. Here I have not used it. Okay. Next point is 6, 0. When x is equal to 6, so 6 is this point. Okay, 6 is this point and 0 is also this point itself. Okay, so 6, 0. So x-axis is 6 and y-axis is 0. 6, 0. Next is 9, 1. So here 9 is this point. So this is 9 and 1 is this point. So 1 is exactly center of it. Okay, so this is 1. So this is 9, 1. Fine. 9, 1. So next is exactly the same point. This 42, 11. Okay. So from here we need to join the point. So this is 6. From here 9, 1. Okay, next straightly to join this point. Okay, you need to join this point. Fine. So this is the intersecting point. So see here, this is the 6, 0 point. Okay, 6, 0, and this is 9, 1 point. And draw a straight line so that it will touch this intersecting point 42, 12. Okay, so this is the intersecting point. So write as the lines are intersecting. The lines are intersecting. Hope you understood this problem. Moving on to the second problem. The second problem is the coach of a cricket team buys 3 bats and 6 balls for ₹3,900. Okay, 3 bats and 6 balls. Let bat be x and ball be y. Okay, so in the first they have given that 3 bats and 6 balls. Okay, the first equation will turns out to be 3 bats and 6 balls, which is equal to 3900. Okay, since all the three numbers are divisible by a single digit, we can divide it. That is, divide throughout by 3. So 3 ones are here, 3 twos are 3 1,300s. Okay, the equation will become x plus 2y is equal to 1,300. So this is equation number 1. Okay, so next read out the continuation of the question. Later she buys another bat. Another means one. Okay, so another bat plus 3 more balls of the same kind for rupees 1,300. We can't divide it. Okay, let this be equation number 2. Next, here you can clearly see that here A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Because A1 by A2 is 1 by 1, which is not equal to 2 by 3. So, the graph will be intersecting. Right? So, if the graph is intersecting, we need to solve these two equations to find out the intersection point. Then solve equation 1 and 2. X plus 2y is equal to 1,300. And x plus 3y is equal to 1,300. Okay, here plus x minus x cancels each other, and plus 1,300 and minus 1,300 also cancels each other. Here plus into minus is, so unlike signs, if unlike signs come, we need to subtract it. So 3 minus 2 is 1y, where the larger number signifies minus, so is equal to 0. So y is also equal to 0. Here y is equal to 0. When y becomes 0, we need to substitute it to either equation 1 or 2. Okay, so I will be substituting in equation 1, that is x plus 2y is equal to 1,300. So here in the place of y, we need to substitute it as 0. So 2 into 0 is 0 itself. So the value of x is 1,300. So when x is 1,300, y will be 0, and this point is the intersection point. So xy point, it is 1,300, 0. So this is the intersection point. So after getting this, we need to solve both the equation, okay, by finding out the points of it. So first equation is x plus 2y is equal to 1,300. So 2y is equal to 1,300 minus x. So y is equal to 1,300 minus x divided by 2. Okay, so this is the new form of equation. Next, we need to find out the points. Okay, minimum of 2 points is required, so more than that we can take. So xy, we already know the first intersecting point, that is, if we take x is equal to 0, y will be 1,300, like, right? So that will be the first point I will be taking here, that is x is equal to 0. So when I take x is equal to 0, y will become 1,300. Oh, sorry. So x, I have to take it as 1,300 itself. Okay. So x, I have to take 1,300. Fine. So the first point, x is equal to 1,300. X is 1,300, so y will be 0. Okay. So, y is 1,300 minus the x value is 1,300 itself divided by 2. So, 1,300 minus 1,300 is 0 divided by 2, that is 0 itself. So, when x is 1,300, y will be 0. So, next point is, we can't take small point like 2 or 3 here, because if we subtract it, the number will be very large. So, very large numbers like in hundreds or thousand place numbers, we can't plot it in graph. So, in order to reduce it, we have to take the value of x itself a little bit larger number. Okay, so that number should be divisible by 2. So, see here, I will be taking x is equal to 100. So, I will be taking x is equal to 100. So, what happens? Y is equal to 1,300 minus 100 divided by 2. So, 1,300 minus 100 is 1,200 divided by 2. So, 2, 6 are 12. So, 2 zeros. That is, when x is equal to 100, y will be 600. So, this is one point. Okay. So, next, another one point I will be taking. So, here x is equal to 300. I will be taking x is equal to 300. then y will become 1300 minus 300 divided by 2. So 1300 minus 300 is 1000 divided by 2. That is 2 ones are 2 5s are 10. So it is 500. So when I take x is equal to 300, y will be 500. Okay, understood? So in the same way, we need to calculate the second equation. Okay, so second equation is x plus 3y is equal to 1300. So it will become 3y is equal to 1300 minus x, and y is equal to 1300 minus x divided by 3. So this will be the new equation, right? So this is the new equation. We need to substitute point for that. The first point is already there. That is x is equal to 1300. I will be taking that point itself. X is equal to 1300. Okay. Then y become 1300 minus 1300 divided by 3. So that is 0 divided by 3, which is equal to 0. Okay. I need to write the box for it. Okay. Here x, y. The first point I have taken is 1300. So when I take 1300, the y value will be 0. Okay. Next, the second point. Second point, I will be taking x is equal to 100 itself. Okay. When I take x is equal to 100, it will become 1300 minus 100 divided by 3. So 1300 minus 100 is 1200 divided by 3. So here 3 ones are 3, 4s are 12. So 1200 means 400s are. So when x is 100, y will be 400. Fine? Okay. Next. So this is divide by 3. So here when the number subtracted, it should come over as odd, not even. Okay? Not in the units place, just the number I am telling, in the 100th place, because it is divisible by 3. So 3 2s are 6, either it should be 600, or 3 3s are 9, either it should be 900. Okay? So likewise, we need to subtract it. So I will be taking x is equal to 400, because when I subtract 1300 minus 400, so it turns out to be 900, which is divisible by 3. Okay, so y is equal to 1300 minus 400 divided by 3. So this is 900 divided by 3. So 3 divided by 900 is 300. So when I take x as 400, the quotient is 300. Fine. So this is the values of the box. Now we need to plot the graph for it. So this is the graph of a second question. So the box is already written here, the first box and the second box. Okay, the points in the first box are, for 1300 it is 0. Okay, for 1300, so this is 1300 point, and where the y-axis is 0. For x-axis 1200 300, y-axis is 0. So this is the point. So 1300 and 0. Okay, so next one is 100. For 100 in x-axis, 600 in y-axis. Okay, for 100 in x-axis, 600 in y-axis. For 100 in x-axis, 600 in y-axis. Next is, for 300 in x-axis, 500 in y-axis. So 300 in x-axis, 500 in y-axis. So this is the point. Next we need to draw the line so that it has to touch these points. So it has to touch these points. So next, the second group, again 1300 and 0. Okay, next 100 and 400. For 100 it is 400. For 100 it is 400. Next, for 400 it is 300. So 400 it is 300 in y-axis. Okay, next we need to join the line. need to join the line by using scale and pencil. Right. So the equation for first line, the equation for the first line is 3x plus 6y is equal to 3900. So this is the first equation. And the equation for the second line is x plus 3y is equal to 1300. So here the point is intersecting. So we can write it as the lines are intersecting. The lines are intersecting. I hope you understood this. So this is the third question of exercise 3.1. So the question says the cost of 2 kg of apples. So first we need to take, let apples be x and grapes be y. Okay. Next, the statement goes on 2 kg of apples. 2 kg means 2x plus 1 kg of grapes, that is 1y, on a day was found to be 160. Okay, so this will be equation number 1. So next, and this will be in the form a1x plus b1y is equal to c1. Okay, so that is plus c1 is equal to 0. We need to take 160 this side to left hand side. Okay, after a month the cost of 4 kg apples plus 2 kg grapes is equal to 300. So since all the numbers are divided by a single digit, we can divide it by that digit. Okay, so 2 2s are, 2 1s are, and 2 150s are. That is 2x plus 1y is equal to 150. This is equation number 2. So this will be in the form a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. So first we need to compare the ratios, that is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. Here a1 by a2 is 2 by 2 is equal to b1 by b2 is 1 by 1 is equal to c1 by c2 is minus 160 divided by minus 150. Okay, so if here 2 ones are 2, here minus minus get cancels. So what happens here, 1 by 1 is equal to 1 by 1 but not equal to 160 by 150. Okay, so this will be like a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 but it is not equal to c1 by c2. So what type of graph we will get? So that is parallel. The lines will be parallel. Fine. Now we need to find out the points of each equation. The first equation is 2x, 2x plus 1y, we can simply write it as y, is equal to 160. So y is equal to 160. We need to arrange this equation in the form, it has to come like y is equal to, okay, is equal to 2x. Next, write on the box, minimum 2 points is required, we can take more than that also. So x, y. So here 160 is there. If we take very low number like 1, 2 and 3 single digit, then what happens? We will get a very larger number as the remainder. So if that happens, then the graph will be pretty much longer. So it's better we have to take a little higher number, 2 digit number. Okay. In the first case, I will be taking x is equal to 10. So what it happens, y is equal to 160 minus 2 into, in the place of x, we need to write it as 10. So it will become 160 minus 20. 160 minus 20 is 140. So when I take 10, it will become 140. So next, b, I will be taking x is equal to 20. So y is equal to 160 minus 2 into 20. So it will become 160 minus 40, that is 120. Okay, so when I took 20, it will become 120. So next, third point, x is equal to 30. So y is equal to 160 minus 2 into 30, that is 160 minus 2 3s are 6, so 2 into 30 is 60. We will get 100. So these are the 3 points. When I take 30, it will become 100. So these are the 3 points of the first equation. We need to calculate the points for the second equation also, that is 2x plus y is equal to 150. So y is equal to 150 minus 2x. Next we need to write a box here, and we need to take more than 2 points or 2 points at least. Okay. Here also, in the first case, we can take any 2-digit number. But since it is a parallel lines, we need to show them as a little bit farther to each other. We don't want both of them to merge together. Okay. So I will be taking a little bit higher number. Okay. That is, first I will be taking 20 here. So when I take 20, it will become x is equal to 150 minus 2 into 20. That is 150 minus 40. So it will become 110. Okay. So when I took 20, it will become 110. So next one. So I will be taking 40. So I will be taking like 20 tables. Okay. Multiple of 20. So it will become 150 minus 2 into 40. So that is 150 minus 80. So it will become 70. So next, so when I took 40, so the value is 70. So next, C. So I will be taking 60 here. So y is equal to 150 minus 2 into 60. So this is 150 minus 120. So it will become 30. So when I took 60, the value of y-axis is 30. Okay. So these are the points. Now we need to plot a graph for this. This is the third graphical representation. So I have already mentioned the x-axis line and y-axis line. So where in points you can see here, the x-axis, the maximum number in x-axis is 60. So I have taken 10 units apart. For each centimeter, I have taken 10 units apart. Okay. So 10, 20, 30. So the maximum 60, I have taken one more point, that is 70. Okay. And in y-axis, the maximum number is 140. So in order to minimize the graph, I have taken 20 units apart. Okay. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, another three numbers I have taken. Okay. So x-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 units. And in y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 20 units. Fine. So next, you can see here, in the first group of points, for 10 in x-axis, y-axis is 140. For 10 in x-axis, y-axis is 140. Okay. So for 10, it is 140. So next, in 20, it is 120. For 20 in x-axis, the y-axis is 120. So 20, 120. So next, in 30, it is 100. For 30, it is 100. So for 30, it is 100. Fine. So next, we need to join the point. It is little bit tilted line. Okay. Next, in the second group of collection, for x-axis 20, it is 110. For 20, it is 110. So for 20, it is 110. For 40, it is 70. So here it is 70. For 40, so see here, this is 60, this is 70, and this is 80. So this is the 70 line. For 40, it is 70, and for 60, it is 30. So 30 line is this one. Okay, so 20 and 30 and 40. So this is the 30 line. For 60, it is 30. Next, we need to join it. So this is parallel lines, so both the lines should not intersect each other. So use scale and pencil while drawing the line. Okay, since I'm not using scale here, it might be little bit tilted, but when you are writing it, write it neatly. Okay, so the first point is 20 110. The second point is 40, 70, and the third point is 60, 30. Okay, you need to join this point to this line. So these two lines are considered as parallel. Okay, so right here these lines are parallel since it is not intersecting at any point. These lines are parallel. I hope you understood this. So this is example 4th problem. In my previous video I had explained example 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so still 3 example problems are there. Example 4, 5 and 6. In this session I will be completing this one. So first here we need to check whether the given equation is consistent or not. Consistent means after comparing the ratios it should be either coincident line or intersecting line. If it is coincident or intersecting, then it will be consistent. If it is parallel, then it will be inconsistent. So in the case of only consistent, we have to draw the graph. So if it is inconsistent, then we have to stop the problem there itself. Okay. So first we need to find out the ratios. So here, x plus 3y, I will be taking this 6 to left hand side. So minus 6 is equal to 0. This will be in the form a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. And next 2x minus 3y, I will be taking 12 to left hand side, it will become minus 12 is equal to 0. And the second equation is in the form a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Okay, next we need to compare the ratios. So a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. So a1 by a2, here a1 is 1 and a2 is 2. So 1 by 2 is equal to b1 is 3, b2 is minus 3. B1 is 3 and b2 is minus 3. Here itself we can conclude it. A1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. So if a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then the lines are intersecting. So if the lines are intersecting, therefore it is consistent. Okay, so if it is consistent, then we need to solve the graph. Okay, so but here it is intersecting line. Intersecting line means we need a point of intersection there. So in order to find out the point of intersection, we have to solve these two equations. Okay, so I'll be solving these two equations, that is x plus 3y is equal to 6 and 2x minus 3y is equal to 12. Here you can see here 3y and 3y are same, but we can't cancel it. Why? Because when we change the sign, so after changing the sign here, okay, so when we change it, so it will become plus into plus. Plus into plus is addition we had to do, it will become 6y. So at this case we can't cancel these terms, even though if it is similar in manner. Okay, so only when it comes plus into minus, only in the case of plus into minus, in the case of subtraction itself we have to cancel it. Okay, when it comes like plus into plus, we can't cancel even though it has same similar terms. Fine. So here what we have to do is we need to make this x term as equal to each other, because it will become plus into minus. Fine. In order to make it similar, we need to multiply this term, this whole equation by 2. Okay, so 2 into x is 2x plus 2 3 is a 6y is equal to 2 6 a 12. So second equation write as it is, 2x minus 3y is equal to 12. Next change the sign. So when you change the sign here, here plus 2x minus 2x cancel each other. So plus into plus is, so if like signs come we need to add it. So 6 plus 3 9y, larger number sign is plus itself. Next plus 12 minus 12, this also cancels, so it will become 0. So y is equal to 0 divided by 9, therefore y is equal to 0 itself. Okay, next we need to substitute this y value either for equation 1 or for equation 2. Okay, I will be taking equation 1. So here, so this will be equation 1 and this will be equation 2. So equation 1 is x plus 3y is equal to 6. So in the place of y, we need to substitute 0. So 3 into 0 is 0 itself. Therefore, the x value will be x is equal to 6. Now what happens? At the point 6, 0. Okay, when x-axis, x coordinate is at 6 and y coordinate is at 0, the intersection point will appear. Fine. So next we need to find out the points for each and every equation. That is, first one is x plus 3y is equal to 6. We need to arrange the equation in the form so that it has to come y is equal to. Okay, so 3y is equal to 6 minus x. Next we need to shift this 3 here. So 6 minus x divided by 3. So this will be the equation. So next we need to find out the points for it. Okay. So in the first case, I will be substituting x is equal to 0. So y will become 6 minus 0 divided by 3. That is, 6 minus 0 is 6 divided by 3. 3 ones are 3 twos are. So when I substitute x is equal to 0, so y will become 2. Okay. So next, when I substitute x is equal to 1, 6 minus 1 is 5, which is not divisible by 3. Okay. So next I will substitute x is equal to 2, 6 minus 2 is 4, which is also not divisible by 3. Next, if I take x is equal to 3, 6 minus 3 is 3, which is divisible, right? So first you have to make some mind calculation so that you can understand which points you have to take. So next you have to substitute x is equal to 3. So it will become y is equal to 6 minus 3 divided by 3. 6 minus 3 is 3. That is 3 ones are. Okay. So y is equal to 1. So when I take x is equal to 3, y will be 1. So next point, we already have that point, that is 6, 0. Okay. So third point is, I have to take x is equal to 6. If I take x is equal to 6, y will become 6 minus 6 divided by 3. 6 minus 6 is 0 divided by 3. It will be 0 itself. Okay. So when I take x is equal to 6, y will be 0. So these are the three points. Next, we need to find out the points for second equation. The second equation is 2x minus 3y is equal to 12. Here you have to concentrate a little bit. Why? Because here in first equation, x plus 3y is there. When it is plus 3y, you have to keep this 3y here itself. You need to shift all other terms to left hand side or right hand side. Okay. So only when the y term has a positive sign. In this case, you have to keep this y term here itself and you have to shift the next other terms to other sides. Okay. Here in the case, I will be taking it to left hand side. Then it is, since it is multiplication, when you shift it, it will become divided by first equation. Here in second equation, what happens? To this 3y term, a negative term is there. In this case, first you need to shift this 3y to left hand side and you have to shift this 12 to right hand side. Okay, only in the case you have to shift this y term when it has a negative sign. When it has positive sign, you have to keep it like that itself. Okay, so here 2x, you have to keep it here. 12 you are shifting, so it will become minus 12. Minus 3y, when you shift it, it will become plus 3y. Fine. So next you have to, it is 3 into y. When you are shifting 3 here, it will become divided by. So 2x minus 12 divided by 3 is equal to y. So this is the equation. Fine. So next you have to write down the points for this. Okay. So first point, I will be taking 0 itself. If I take x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2 into 0 minus 12 divided by 3. So 2 into 0 is 0. So the remaining is minus 12 by 3. 3 ones are 3 fours are. Since it has a minus sign, it will become minus 4. Okay. For x is equal to, I am taking negative sign here. So if x is equal to 0, y is minus 4. Okay. So next, second one. So when I substitute x is equal to 1, 2 ones are 2. So 12 minus 2 is 10, which is not divisible by 3. Okay. So next, if I take 2 here, 2 twos are 4. 12 minus 4 is 8. Again, it is not divisible by 3. Next, if I take x is equal to 3, 2 threes are 6. So 12 minus 6 is minus 6 here. It is divisible. So here, the next point, the second point I will be taking, x is equal to 3. So y is equal to 2 into 3 minus 12 whole divided by 3. Here it is 2 3 is 6 minus 12 divided by 3. 12 minus 6 is 6 itself. But we have to retain the negative sign because it is larger number. So minus 6 by 3, 3 1s are 3 2s. Since it is negative, it is minus 2. So when we substitute 3 for x-axis, then it will be minus 2 in y. Okay, last point we already have 6 comma 0. So that is the point. For x, we have to substitute x is equal to 6. So when I substitute x is equal to 6, it will become 2 into 6 minus 12 divided by 3. 2 6 are 12 minus 12 divided by 3. 12 minus 12 is 0 divided by 3. It is also equal to 0. So if I take x as 6, then it will become, y will become 0. So these are the points. Since it is an intersecting graph, so here is the intersection point here. 6, 0 and 6, 0 for both the equations. Okay, hope you understood this. Come, let us do the graphical section. So this is the graphical representation of first example problem, that is fourth example problem. So here x-axis and y-axis, negative x-axis and negative y-axis also I have mentioned here. Because in x-axis, the maximum number is 6. So I have taken from 1 to 8 here, okay. Next, in y-axis, the lowest number is minus 4. That is a negative number. So I have taken, this is the negative y-axis where I have taken minus 4 here. Next, the highest number is 2. So I have taken some more numbers here. So the scale will become, x-axis is 1 centimeter. This each box is considered as 1 centimeter. So if it is 1 centimeter, it is 1 unit. And y-axis also for 1 centimeter, I have taken only 1 units for both x-axis and y-axis. Next, we have to plot the graph for first point. This is the first collection of point and this is the second collection of point for both the equations. For 0 in x-axis, 2 will be in y-axis. For 0 in x-axis, 2 will be in y-axis. Okay, so this is the first point. Next, for 3 in x-axis, 3 in x-axis, 1 in y-axis. Next, 6 in x-axis, 0 in y-axis. So this is the point. First, we need to join the line for that. Okay. So here, this is 0, 2. This is 3, 1. And this is 6, 0. Okay, these are the 3 points for first equation. And the second is, for 0 it is minus 4. So this is 0 minus 4. And second is, for 3 it is minus 2. So this is 3 minus 2. And next one is 6, 0. So intersection at 6, 0. So this point is 0, minus 4. And this is 3, minus 2. And 6, 0 is the point of intersection. So here we can write 6, 0 point of intersection. Okay, 6, 0 point of intersection. And we need to write here, these lines are intersecting. These lines are intersecting. I hope you understood this. Write neatly using scale and pencil. Okay. This is example 5 question. Here, first we have to find out whether the given equations have no solution, unique solution, or infinitely many solution. Means, if it is no solution means it is parallel, unique solution means intersecting, and infinitely many solution means coincident. First we need to find out whether the equations are consistent or inconsistent. Okay, so later after finding that, we have to plot the graph for that. So here, this is the first equation, 5x minus 8y plus 1. The second equation is in the form of a fraction. If it is in the form of a fraction, then it will become tedious for us to solve the problem. So I will be multiplying it with 5 by 3. So here it is 3 by 5. In order to cancel this, I am taking 5 by 3. Okay. Multiply by 5 by 3. So here 3x into 5 by 3 minus 24y by 5 into 5 by 3 plus 3 by 5 into 5 by 3. Okay, we need to multiply each and every term by 5/3. Okay, here 3, 3 get cancels each other. Here 5, 5 cancels and 3, 1s are 3, 8s are. Here 3 and 5 both get cancels each other. The remaining will be here 5 into x, 5x minus 8 into y, 8y plus. So everything has cancelled. So the remaining will be 1 is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. We can see here equation 1 and equation 2 both are same. Okay. So when we compare the equations by ratios, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by v2 is equal to c1 by c2. Then a1 by a2 is 5 by 5 is equal to b1 by b2 is minus 8 by minus 8 is equal to c1 by c2 is 1 by 1. So when we cancel it, it will become 1 by 1, 1 by 1 and 1 by 1. So if a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 and it is also equal to c1 by c2, then the lines will be, the lines are coincident. Okay, when the lines are coincident, then it is consistent. Okay, so this is the thing we need to first find out. Okay, after this, what we have to do? We need to find out the points and plot the graph for it. Okay, since each equation, since both equations are same, we can calculate the point only one time. Okay, so 5x minus 8y plus 1 is equal to 0. Here you can note it down. That is, this y term has negative sign. When it has negative sign, we need to shift it to this side. Okay, so keep this 5x plus 1 here itself. After shifting, it will become plus 8y. Next, we need to shift this 8 into y. Here, 8 to left hand side, it will become 5x plus 1 divided by 8 is equal to y. So, this is the equation. For that, we need to substitute the value for x. Okay. We need to find out the points for this. Minimum of 2 points is required to plot a graph. Okay. Minimum of 2 points. Maximum, we can take how many numbers we want. Okay. First one, you see here the equation is y is equal to 5x plus 1 divided by 8. So this is the equation. So when I substitute 0 here, okay, if I substitute 0, 5 into 0 is 0, then the remaining is 1 by 8. So 1 by 8 will be a fraction, or it will convert into decimal form, which we don't want. Okay, so if I substitute 1 here, 5 1s are 5, 5 plus 1, 6 is not divisible by 8. So next, 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 1 is 11, 11 is also not divisible by 8. Next, I will substitute 3 here, 5 3s are 15, 15 plus 1 is 16, 16 is divisible. So the first number is x is equal to 3, okay. So when I put x is equal to 3, so it will become 5 into 3 plus 1 divided by 8. So that is 5 3s are 15 plus 1 divided by 8. That is 16 divided by 8. 8 1s are 8 2s are. So when I substitute x as 3, the y axis will be 2. Okay. So next, in the same way, we need to calculate another 1 point. Okay. So 3 is over. If I substitute 4 here, 5 4s are 20. 20 plus 1, 21, which is not divisible. Next, 5 5s are 25. 25 plus 1, 26 is also not divisible. Next, 6. 5 6s are 30, 30 plus 1, 31 is also not divisible. Next, 5 7s are 35, 35 plus 1 is 36, not divisible. Next, 7, 5 7s are, okay, 5 7s are 35 plus 1, 36 is over. Next, 8, 5 8s are 40, 40 plus 1, 41 is also not divisible. Next, 9, 5 9s are 45, 45 plus 1, 46, I'm sorry, 5 9s are 45, 45 plus 1 is, it is also not divisible. Next, 10, 50 plus 1, 51 is also not divisible. Okay, next is 11, 5 11s are 55, 55 plus 1 is 56, which is divisible. Okay, like that you have to think it of. Each and every number you have to substitute it. Instead of writing, you can make mind calculation. Okay, if it is not possible, you can write it also. But only those number which we will get a whole number, only those points you have to enter in this points column. Okay, so here the next number is x is equal to 11. So when I substitute x is equal to 11, it will become 5 into 11 plus 1 divided by 8. So 5 11s are 55 plus 1 divided by 8. So 55 plus 1 is 56 divided by 8. So 8 7s are 56. Okay, so here when I substitute x is equal to 11, so y is 7 here. Fine. So since both the equations are same, equation 2 is also same here. Okay, equation 2 will also be having the same points. You can write the points directly. There is no need of writing the calculation part because both are same. Okay, xy for 3 it will be 2 and for 11 it will be 7. Okay, so these are the collection of points which we need to plot the graph using it. Okay, so moving on to the graphical representation of this part. So here the points are in x-axis the maximum point is 11. So I have taken for 1 centimeter apart, I have taken up to 13 numbers. Okay, in y-axis the maximum number is 7. So here also 1 centimeter apart and 1 units, I have taken 10. Okay, here x-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit, and for y-axis also 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit. Okay, in the first point x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 2. For x-axis 3, y is equal to 2. So this is the point. Okay, so for x-axis 3, y is 2. So next one is for x-axis 11, y is 7. Okay, so 7 is this point. For x-axis 11, y is 7. Fine, so this is the 7th point in y-axis and 11th point in x-axis. Okay, so next we need to join the line. Since it is a coincident line, so two lines will be merging with each other because the two points are one and the same. We don't have to mark the point two times. Okay, after joining the line we need to write two arrow marks here. So these two arrow marks considers there are two lines are passing through the point. Okay, so write the equation here. The equations are 5x minus 8y plus 1 is equal to 0. So this is the equation. Next we have to write these lines are coincident. These lines are coincident. Fine. I hope you understood this. This is the last problem of this session. Example 6. So example 6 is Champa went to a sale and purchased some pants and skirts. Okay. So let the pant be x and skirt be y. Okay, let the pant be x and skirt be y. So when her friends asked her how many of each she had bought, she answered the number of skirts is, skirt is y, right? So the number of skirt is 2 less than, less means you have to subtract this. Okay, 2 less than twice the number of pants. Pant is substituted by x, so twice the number of pants. She told the number of skirts is, skirt is signified by y, is 2 less. 2 less means minus 2. 2 less than twice the number of pants. Twice means 2x. Okay, y is equal to 2x minus 2. This is equation number 1. So next one, purchased. Also the number of skirts is, again one more equation, the number of skirts is 4 less than. So first it was 2 less than, now it is 4 less than, 4 times the number of pants, that is 4x minus 4. So this is equation number 2. Okay, you have to read the question carefully and you have to write the equation here. So the number of skirts is equal to 2 less than twice the number of pants, and the number of skirts is 4 less than 4 times the number of skirts. Okay, pant. So this is the equation. So next what we have to do is we need to find it out whether it is coincident, intersecting or parallel. So we have to form it in an equation form, that is ax plus by plus c form. Okay, so keep this 2x there itself. You have to shift this y to right hand side. It will become minus y, minus 2 as it is 0. So this will be a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. Next equation, write 4x as it is, shift y there and write minus 4 as it is. It will be a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Next we need to compare the equations. Okay, that is compare the ratios. a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. Here a1 by a2 is 2 by 4 is equal to b1 by b2 is minus 1 by minus 1, which is absolutely not equal. So a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then the lines are intersecting. Okay, so when we get lines are intersecting, we need to solve the equation in order to find out the intersecting point, right? So write the first equation, that is 2x minus y. So 2x minus y, so shift this minus 2 to right hand side, it will become 2. Okay, next one is 4x minus y is equal to 4. Next, change the sign here, plus into minus minus, so this middle term cancels each other, plus into minus minus, so 4 minus 2 is 2x, larger number sign you have to write. Next, plus into minus minus, 4 minus 2 is 2, larger number sign is minus. So here 2 get minus minus get cancels each other, x is equal to 2 divided by 2, so x is equal to 1. Okay, so this is 1, so we need to substitute it to first equation. Okay, so first equation is here. Okay, so first equation we can substitute it, that is first equation is in equation 1. So first equation is y is equal to 2x minus 2, so y is equal to 2 into, in the place of x we need to write 1 here. Okay, y is equal to 2 minus 2, y is equal to 0. Okay, so the interesting intersecting point is x comma y, that is 1 comma 0. So at this point the two lines for the equation will intersect. Okay, so the next step is we need to find out the points. So first equation is y is equal to 2x minus 2. Okay, next put a box here. First I will substitute 1 itself. Okay, so x is equal to 1. When I substitute 1, it will become 2 into 1 minus 2. So y is equal to 2 ones are 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. So when I substitute 1, y axis will be 0. Next I will be substituting 2. X is equal to 2. So y is equal to 2 into 2 minus 2, that is 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. Okay, so when I substitute x is equal to 2, y is also equal to 2. Next, last point, see, x is equal to 3 I will be substituting. So y is equal to 2 into 3 minus 2, so 2 3s are 6 minus 2, that is 4. So when I substitute 3 here, the y axis will be 4. So these are the points for first equation. So let us find out the value for second equation, 4x minus 4. Okay, so here we need to draw one more box. Okay, so again for the first point I will be taking 1 itself. So y is equal to 4 into 1 minus 4, that is 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. For x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0. Next, second, x is equal to 2. So y is equal to 4 into 2 minus 4, that is 4 2s are 8 minus 4 is 4. Okay, when I substitute x is equal to 2, the answer for y is 4. Next, last one, x is equal to 3. So y is equal to 4 into 3 minus 4. So 4 3s are 12 minus 4 is 8. So for x is equal to 3, the y value will be 8. So these are the points which we have to plot the graph by using these two points. Okay, so this one is the last graphical representation. So here the maximum point in x-axis is 3. So we can take 1 centimeter apart for 1 unit. Okay, 1, 2, 3 and one more point, 4. Next, for y-axis, the maximum number is 8. Here also we can take 1 centimeter apart, 1 unit. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. One more point I have taken here. So for first point, 1, for x-axis 1, y-axis is 0. Okay, for x-axis 1, y-axis is 0. This is the point. And next point is for x-axis 2, y-axis also 2. So this is the point. For x-axis 3, y-axis is 4. So this is the point. Next we need to join the points. Okay, so this is the point. Next one is 1,0 for second point. This is 1,0. Next 2,4. For 2 it is 4, and 3,8. For 3 it is 8. So this is the point. So this is 1,0 point, and this one is 2,2 point, and this is 3,4. So this one is 2,4, and this one is 3,8. Fine. So here both the lines are intersecting at point 1,0. So this is the intersecting point. You can write it here. 1,0 is the intersection point, and these lines are intersected. I hope you understood my graphical representations and all. If you have any doubts, please comment me in the comment section. And if you have any suggestions pertaining to this graph also, you can just suggest me so that I can improve the graphical representation. The only mistake is I have not used a scale here, but please practice graphical questions carefully because it is very important question for you.